Dorothy, and welcome back to my channel. This week I have a second Christmas video for you guys, and it's DIY Christmas treats. I had a very special guest help me with this video, so if she wants to come on in, you guys might recognize her. She is, in fact, my sister. Make sure to like this video and subscribe for more videos every week, and let's just get on with the video.
Ho, ho, ho!
Now this first treat is super delicious, so all you're going to need is some Rice Krispie treats, some lollipop sticks or cake pop sticks, white chocolate, and some sprinkles. The first thing you're going to want to do is take out your Rice Krispies and stick the sticks into them. So you're just going to want to do that with however many you have. Now you're going to want to pour your white chocolate onto a pan on the stove. And I set it at the highest setting, but it all depends on what you feel comfortable with. And now I'm just taking my Rice Krispies and dipping them into the melted white chocolate.
Wait, do that again.
I would advise you guys to do this with a spoon rather than just dipping the Rice Krispie in because it can easily fall off.
To the sprinkle station, let's go!
And now I am just pouring sprinkles onto the Rice Krispies to give it that Christmassy look. And you're done! This was probably my favorite out of all of them and probably the easiest. It's Christmas time! And now onto the second treat. So this is the prettiest treat by far. And so what you're gonna need is some parchment paper in a pan, lollipop sticks, white chocolate, and some mini candy canes. Also some sprinkles. So what you're gonna wanna do is set up your mini candy canes into the shape of a heart. And when you're done with that, you're gonna wanna melt your white chocolate, so the same thing as before. Now when you're done with that, you're going to want to take a spoonful of white chocolate and put it into the heart shape and then stick the lollipop stick in. Now I'm just adding my sprinkles and I decided to go with the colorful theme, but you can totally make this Christmas theme if you want. And now I'm just sticking it in the refrigerator for 10 minutes and now you have your beautiful mini heart candy cane treats. Now onto the third treat. So these are present pretzels. So first what you're going to need is some parchment paper, waffle pretzels, M&Ms and a knife or pill cutter, dark chocolate, and a bowl. So now I'm taking my pill cutter, you can totally use a knife, it's up to you, and just cutting my M&Ms in half. And now I'm just taking my dark chocolate and splitting them up into pieces. I try to do as tiny as pieces as I can to help the melting go a little bit faster. Now I'm dumping the chocolate onto the stove, letting it melt, and now taking the pretzels and dipping 1/3 of it in to make it the top of the present. Now taking my M&Ms, I'm putting them on the top to serve as a bow and putting two on the bottom. So as you can see, mine turned out a little bit messy. But you get the idea. They kind of look like presents and they taste really good. And the fourth treat. So these are probably the cutest treat yet. So all you're going to need is some cookie batter, chocolate pretzels, and M&Ms. I just got my cookie batter store made, but you can totally make your own if you want. So I just laid mine out, stuck them in the oven, and while I was waiting, I, you know, just had a dance party as one would. And when they were done, I took my chocolate-covered pretzels and my M&Ms and stuck them in as soon as I could because the fresher the cookie, the better they will stick. So I'm just taking my mini M&Ms and those are serving as the eyes, then the bigger M&M as the nose, and the chocolate pretzels as the antlers.
And we're back! Did you guys miss us?
You know you did.
Thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed, make sure to like this video once again.
And subscribe.
Subscribe, that's right. We'll see you guys next week with another Christmas video. 'You come over here, we have an open fridge waiting for us. Whoa.
What a coincidence. You just did it for 12 hours.
And that's how you set a timer.